In this video, we will demonstrate how to install a CO series mortise lock. These are the tools you'll need for this installation. First, prepare the door for your installation. A self-adhesive template is included in the box. This step is only for the CO200 and CO250. On the outside assembly, carefully remove the mylar strip. This step is only for locks with a privacy function. Feed the door position switch wires through the hole in the door edge. Run the wires through the upper hole on the inside of the door, then push the sensor into the opening. Install the companion door position switch magnet into the hole in the frame. Close the door to check for alignment. Next, check the handing of the outside assembly. The knob stop pin should be pointing toward the latch edge of the door. If the handing is not correct, rehand it now. To rehand the lock, refer to the installation instructions. Install the lever and cylinder onto the outside assembly. Insert a Phillips head screwdriver into the cam of the outside assembly and rotate it clockwise until it stops. Place the cylinder into the lever, and while holding the cylinder in place, insert the key. Turn the key 90 degrees clockwise and push the lever over the spindle. Depress the knob stop pin using the lever removal tool and continue pushing the lever on until you hear a click. Install the set screw into the lever. Check that the lever and the cylinder have seated correctly by turning the key and removing it from the cylinder. Ensuring correct alignment of the latch, slide the mortise chassis into the door, being careful not to pinch any wires. If there is a deadbolt, be sure to thread the cable through the upper hole. On the back of the outside assembly, make sure the two orientation triangles are lined up. Use one of the spindles to align them. Install the spindle standoff posts as shown for a left-handed lock. If your lock is right-handed, install them here. Then install the four corner standoff posts into the outside assembly and tighten. Insert the spindle into the outside assembly with the beveled square end pointing outward. Install the grommet on the inside of the door. Install the outside assembly onto the door. Feed the ribbon cable through the grommeted hole, then align the two standoff posts with the holes in the mortise chassis. Push the assembly flush to the door. Secure the outside assembly by installing the anti-rotation plate on the inside of the door. Center the plate vertically and align holes in the anti-rotation plate with the spindle standoff posts. Secure with two flathead screws. From the inside of the door, use the two screws with washers and secure the bottom two standoff posts of the outside assembly. Secure the mortise chassis in position by inserting and tightening the two screws into the door edge. Center the faceplate over the mortise chassis. Insert the two flathead screws into the top and bottom holes and tighten. Next, locate the spring cage assembly and separate the rows from the spring cage body. Now, holding the spring cage assembly in your hand, insert the cam, the spring, and the spindle with the beveled end pointing outward. Fit the spring cage over the anti-rotation plate. Make sure the knob stop pin points toward the latch. Secure the spring cage in place by inserting and tightening the two screws on the top and bottom. Replace the rows and rotate it clockwise until it clicks into place. Slide the inside lever over the spindle, using the lever removal tool to depress the knob stop pin. You should hear a click when it is properly seated. Test the mechanical function by turning and releasing the lever to ensure the latch fully retracts. Holding the inside assembly, route the ribbon cable and any other wires through the corresponding holes. Push the assembly flush to the door, making sure that no wires or cables are pinched. Secure the inside assembly by installing the two screws into the top of the assembly. Connect the ribbon cable by first ensuring the red wire is on the left, then gently push it into the corresponding connector on the inside assembly. This step is only for locks with a privacy function. Connect the door position switch wires into the terminal block as shown. This step is only for locks with a deadbolt. Insert the deadbolt position switch plug into the corresponding connector. Carefully tuck all wires as shown into the inside assembly. Insert the four AA batteries into the battery holder, noting proper polarity as shown. Install the battery holder into the assembly with the cable pointing to the right. Place the battery strap over the holder and install the screws on the top and bottom. Connect the battery plug and tuck the wires carefully below the battery holder. Place the cover onto the inside assembly and secure it with a screw. On the outside lever, insert the key and turn to verify full latch retraction. Complete the mechanical installation by preparing the door frame and installing the strike. For more information, consult your user guide.